So Andrew, we've covered quite a few areas of your health history and talked through most of the lab and the diagnostic studies that we do in the early part of pregnancy. So you seem to be in good health. So it's very reassuring, and I appreciate your taking the time. You know, it's kind of tedious to go through all this, but it's really helpful for us to get a baseline and to understand kind of where you are in your health status. Are you doing okay with all the questions?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, great. So I appreciate that. The next area we want to talk about includes some questions about lifestyles and behaviors. So we're going to specifically look at things that risks and exposures that could put pregnant women or their babies at risk. So those are the areas that we want to cover. We're going to include questions about violence, about drug and alcohol and tobacco use, and sexual behaviors and safety. I review these topics with everybody, so I want you to know I'm not here to judge, I'm not making assumptions, but I'm going to cover these with everybody. Are we okay with that?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, great. Thanks a lot. So let's go over some of the lifestyle questions we're going to do. We're going to do tobacco and alcohol first. You know, there's a stigma, as you can imagine, and sometimes shame associated with alcohol and tobacco use, especially for women that are pregnant. So it makes it difficult sometimes. And I just want you to know that we ask these problems, these questions to everybody. We'll cover that. And I want you to feel comfortable that I'm not here to judge, okay?
Okay.
Okay, great. So the number of women and infants that are affected by alcohol and tobacco in particular is surprisingly high. So both of those things are fairly common in our culture. And so the other thing about it is that those are behaviors that can be changed and those conditions can be prevented if we jump in. Does that all make sense?
Yes.
Okay. It's important for you to know, for us to get a sense of your exposure to tobacco or smoking. Can you say, have you ever smoked or do you smoke now?
Yes, I do smoke, but I've cut back since I found out that I've been pregnant.
You've made an effort to cut back. That's great. So it's important for you to know that quitting smoking is one of the most important things we can do when you're pregnant. So we're really going to want to focus on that. So have you thought about that? Have you thought about trying to cut back and quit?
Yes, it's important to me to cut back, but I do have some concerns. It seems like it'll be really hard.
It's tough. I would imagine you've tried already a little to quit.
Yes, I have cut back, but like I said, it's hard.
It's one of the techniques people use to cope with stress sometimes. Do you find that tobacco is a stress reliever for you?
Yes. Yeah.
That's going to make it hard, but some of the things that can help. Again, it's going to be important to quit entirely if we can. So focusing on some of the positive behaviors. So the negative part is it's a stress reduction for you, but the positives are, your baby's going to get more oxygen. So tobacco does really constrict the oxygen flow to the baby, and I'm sure that's something that you know is important to do. That's going to happen right away. Your baby will be less likely to have bronchitis or asthma if you don't expose the baby to smoke. Your baby's less likely to be born early, so more likely to be born on time and to come home with you from the hospital. And then you're going to feel a lot better. You'll begin, once you get the tobacco out of your system, you're going to breathe easier, you're going to feel a lot more confident about your health, and less likely to suffer many of the health consequences of smoking. I'm sure you plan to quit sometime.
Right, yeah. I guess I have some concerns, like how will I handle the cravings?
Yeah, that's a common enough problem. So having an alternative to put in there is going to be important too. So, and again, focusing on the benefits. So part of it is the loss. The craving is the loss that's part of the addiction of smoking. But the benefits are really going to help. You probably heard the term cold turkey. So quitting all of a sudden at once can be really, really difficult. But I think, again, knowing the harm that smoking causes is one of the techniques we use to kind of help cut back a little bit. Over that. Are you ready to make a plan to quit? Do you think about setting a date or getting started?
Yeah, I think I can do that.
Great. The withdrawal symptoms that you're feeling, if you have cut back a little bit, have you started to notice that already and you tended to cut back that you've had some cravings?
Yeah, and I guess I'm also concerned that I might gain weight. I heard that you gain weight, and I'm already worried about gaining weight because I'm pregnant, so...
Right. Well, weight gain, as you know, is normal in pregnancy. We expect a little bit of that to happen. And one thing to keep in mind is most people that quit smoking, about 10 pounds is kind of the typical weight gain associated. And we can have a plan for that. And that 10 pounds, if you were to gain that, is certainly less harmful than the tobacco smoke. So it's a trade-off, a little bit of a trade-off. And again, we can definitely work on the weight gain. We're going to talk about that anyway as part of your normal pregnancy. So we can get through that a little bit. And there is some good support to get through the cravings also. So there's a quit line that we can set you up with. In fact, we're going to want you to make a call on that before you go today just to get comfortable with that quit line. And we have lots of good information for you. So What do you think? You ready to make a plan to quit?
Yes.
Can we set a date?
Sure.
Before the next visit, maybe? Would that be reasonable? Can you get your plans together to be able to do that?
Yeah, maybe. I think I have to come back in a month, so maybe a few days before my next appointment. I don't want to quit too soon and relapse.
Well, you're being thoughtful about it. That's smart. I think that's a good idea. And you've got a date. If you've got a plan, if you're comfortable with it, I'm comfortable with it. I'm going to support that. Okay. Can I just share a few more things that you can do about those triggers? I know you're a little bit worried about some of those. So, you know, telling your family and friends that you're quitting and why you're quitting is going to help a lot, because that just raises your motivation to be successful. And then having some alternatives for the nicotine withdrawal. Again, it's going to go quick, but for the first few days, even the first few weeks, you can struggle a little bit. You know, get some strategies. Other smokers, you know, what you're going to do when they're around, have an escape route that you can do. Try to get all the tobacco products out of the house and be ready for that. And then again, we're going to call the quit line before you go, so you've got that connection. And they have somebody on call 24/7 that can take your phone call and kind of help you through whatever situation comes up. It's hard. It's not your fault. It's just the way it is. But of course, you're going to want to do it. I appreciate the way you handled that. I think it was great. It's a difficult conversation, but I like that you've set a date. That's very, very good. We're going to keep moving, okay?
Sure.
A lot to cover. So I'm going to talk a little bit about alcohol now. And alcohol is common. It's used a lot. About 1 out of 3 women report alcohol use around the time of pregnancy. So tell me about your experience with alcohol.
Well, I'm not like an alcoholic or anything, but I do enjoy wine. Growing up, you know, wine and mixed drinks are a big part of like my culture. So, I mean, I have a pretty good handle on it. I know my limits, and I mean, I'm not drinking to get drunk or anything like that. And I mean, I know that drinking too much isn't good for my baby, so I'm cutting back.
Well, I appreciate your sharing that with me. I mean, I think alcohol is an important topic, and that you shared honestly with it, and I appreciate your family and cultural values on that and how you kind of grow up with drinking. I also really heard that you want to do what's best for you and the baby, and I think that's great. That's obviously a good motivator. You know, unfortunately, there's no safe amount of alcohol to use in pregnancy, so cutting back is a great idea. We really push stopping entirely. So I know it sounds hard. I just pushed you on the alcohol, smoking, and now we're talking about alcohol. But it's really, really important to come up with a plan to quit. It sounds like you're accustomed to drinking a little bit every day. Is that just part of your lifestyle right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you have been trying to cut down some. How's that going? Is it? Are you able to cut down?
I mean, well, truthfully, I have found it to be a little bit more difficult to cut back since I've been pregnant. You know, like my husband's mad at me. He wants me to cut back since he's been making changes. But I guess, I don't know, my mom and my aunt, they drank throughout all their pregnancies and we're fine.
Right. Yeah, I hear you. I appreciate your sharing that, and I can understand the challenges that you're facing with that. So I think you know, when you're dealing with so many different emotions and trying to kind of come up with the right answer, I think just go right with what we know. And so we really know that alcohol's it's toxic for the baby. So and I know you would never want to do anything to harm the pregnancy. So I think that's what you're torn with a little bit about how to manage this. So I think, you know, we're going to want to come up with a quit plan. It's difficult to do. Your culture and your history, your body sounds like it's developed some dependency also on alcohol. But it is the right thing to do. So let me say again, I'm not here to judge, right? I know you want to do what's right, but we do need to come up with a plan a little bit on how to move forward. So do you think we could think about maybe getting some help, talking to somebody else about this? Would you be open to that?
Yeah.
Yeah, it really deserves a lot more time than we've got into a lot here today, and I don't want to just leave it hanging. So I have a colleague who deals with women and addiction, and I know it's a big word to use right now, but it sounds like there are some dependency issues, and I think it really would help you to talk to her, and I'd like to set something up right away for you. Would you be willing to do that? Great.
Yeah.
I know it's going to be hard. I mean, we covered a lot here today, but thank you so much for your honesty. And again, I'm not here to judge. I'm here to help. You can share with me anything, and I definitely want to hear how it's going when I see you again, okay? The last area we're going to jump into is intimate partner violence or domestic violence, as you may have it. And you were kind enough to fill out the screening form in advance. I've been able to take a look at that. My staff screened that with you. So it sounds like things are going okay for you right now. Are you now or have you ever been in a relationship where you were hurt or threatened by a current or former husband or partner? I really want to know because it's so important.
Oh, no, no. My husband, he's great. I'm lucky. I mean, I know people who've been through all that, but no, I'm good.
That's great. I'm glad to hear that. So it's good to have support, and it sounds like you would be comfortable talking about it if there was ever a problem like that. Mm-hmm. Your partner doesn't do anything that hurts you or makes you feel afraid. Never been in a situation like that?
Oh, no.
That's great. No. Okay, thanks for sharing that. If there, anything like that ever comes up, I want you to feel comfortable talking to me about it. Everybody has their own experience with trauma and violence, so and it's really important. And those episodes do tend to increase in pregnancy. So if anything like that comes up, will you be sure to let us know?
Yeah.
Okay. We covered a lot today, and I really appreciate how you handled all of it. I know I pushed hard a little bit, and there's going to be a lot of questions when you leave. I'm going to step out. I'm going to get some of the printed information that we talked about and have for you, and have my staff set up an appointment with the counselor. And I'll come back and check in with you in a little bit to make sure, see if you have any questions, okay?
Okay.
Thanks a lot. It's good talking to you,
dude. Thank you.
Nice to see you.
You too.
Okay, thanks.